All right, so we've gotten camp broken down. We've left this campsite better than we found it. We picked a lot of the wood clean for our campfire last night. You can see the fire ring. Rehabbed it. Rehabbed another fire ring here on the Pinhoti. So this is a really good campsite. I would highly recommend, if you're coming through here, that you know, to push on to this one if you've got a few more miles to go. Water was great. The benches were awesome. This is outstanding. But like I mentioned last night, there's a little pool about 150 yards down that you can bathe off in if it's in the summertime. We were able to successfully get, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 duplexes, two-person tents in this area. Looks like everybody's heading up the trail. And I'm going to move on myself. Coming up on the 281's crossover of I-20, Interstate 20, that goes to Atlanta. Looks like the guys are waiting on me. The third one I've been denied.
You have no feeling in that. You gotta run. Two miles for the next 281 and then five for the final.
Dropping back into the woods just past the I-20. So the guys walked right by this snake. And he does not care.
I wonder how they deal with snakes and stuff. I mean, you know, they live with them.
This is the Pinhoti Indian cave. You can see the soot that's up on the rock. They would have a fire in here. You saw that grinding hole where they would grind probably acorns. Said Native American, probably most likely Creek Indian here in the Talladega National Forest. Crossing over Highway 78 on the Pinhoti. You can see the sign for the Shoal Creek Ranger Station.